So this is Dr. T. V. Rao, Professor and Principal, DBS Institute of Technology. So today I am going to explain conductive heat transfer in a composite wall. Okay. So conduction heat transfer in a composite wall. Okay. So first of all, what is meant by composite wall? Composite wall means, okay, so if there is more than one slab means a wall, more than one slab is attached with the if you find, then we can call it as a composite slab. Okay, there will be layers. Okay, generally in some cases, some applications, they keep some metal layers, they keep some asbestos layer, they keep some clay layer, like this. There will be a combination of layers. This combination of layers will call it as a composite wall. Okay. So this composite wall, how there is a conductive heat transfer, how conduction takes place in case of a composite wall? Or if there is a composite wall, how to calculate conductive heat transfer? There is one side, there will be one temperature, there will be other side, there will be another temperature. In such cases, how to calculate the heat transfer? Okay, because these three layers will have three different properties. Okay, we'll see. So last class we discussed for a single wall, for a plane wall, how there is a heat transfer, that we discussed. So today's class we'll discuss in case of a composite wall, how there is a heat transfer. Okay. So this is a composite wall. So one side there will be a hot environment, hot fluid, other side there will be a cold fluid. Okay. So there are three walls. A is one slab, one wall, B is another wall, and C is another wall. So here line we are unable to see. So there are three walls. Okay. This composite wall consists of three walls. Okay. So it consists of three walls. So wall A, wall B, and wall C. So one side the temperature is T infinity, other side the temperature is T infinity 4, T infinity 1 and T infinity 4. So the surface temperature is T1. Here, second wall starting temperature is T2, third wall starting temperature is T3, and fourth wall, so this third wall ends with the temperature T4. So this wall A, with a thickness of LA, this thickness is LB, and wall C thickness will be LC. So these three walls have thermal conductivities of KA, KB, and KC. So there is a heat transfer of Q. There is a heat transfer of Q. So here you want to find out the heat transfer means, here we know the temperature of T1, we know the temperature of T4, but in between we don't know what is T2 and what is T3. In such cases, so you have to find out a formula, heat transfer formula, which is a function of T1 and T4. Okay. For that, to simplify this composite wall situation, this will convert into electrical analogy. Electrical analogy means this heat transfer will convert into thermal resistances. So for what? So this is the, so outside the wall there will be a convection, inside the wall there is a conduction. So this is one convection, this is one convection, and there are three conductive heat transfers, total five. Okay, so let's take, this is starting point T0, T infinity 1, and here there is a convective resistance 1 by H1A, and from T1 to T2 there is a conductive resistance L1 by K1A, T2 to T3 again conductive resistance L3 by K3A, and like this. This using this thermal conductivities and convective heat transfer coefficients, this we convert into thermal resistance. Okay. So this is this is starting temperature, and this will be the ending temperature. So once we convert into electrical analogy, so calculation of heat transfer will be very simple. Okay. So this is R, this is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. So the total resistance will be total resistance sigma R. Sigma R is nothing but R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5. Like this, you can find out total resistances. Once you know total resistance, so how to calculate heat transfer? So simply, heat transfer is nothing but delta T by R. Once you know the total resistance for a composite wall, so Q is nothing but delta T. Delta T means starting temperature minus ending temperature by R. So like this, we can find out the heat transfer in a composite wall. And so here, so there are various thermal coefficients. So K is thermal conductivity, H is convective heat transfer coefficients. Like this, Ka, Kb, Kc, H1 and H2. Okay. So like this, there are various thermal coefficients, heat transfer coefficients. In such cases, how to find out overall heat transfer coefficient? To find out the overall heat transfer coefficient, there is an equation. Heat transfer is nothing but overall heat transfer coefficient into delta A. Heat transfer Qx, heat flux. Heat flux is nothing but overall heat transfer coefficient to delta T. So then what is overall heat transfer coefficient is nothing but Qx by delta T. Okay. So this, if you simplify, you will get equation U is nothing but, so UA equal to 1 by R total, or R total equal to 1 by UA. So using this equation, we can find out overall heat transfer coefficient. So this overall heat transfer coefficients, generally we will, using this overall heat transfer coefficient, we will find out the heat transfer in composite walls or in some complex. So where there is a heat in conduction, convection, radiation, in such cases, we use the concept of overall heat transfer coefficient. In some cases, there will be some walls are parallel, some walls are series. In such cases, those problems also we will simplify using this electrical analogy. So electrical analogy, this arrangement of walls will keep in series and parallel. Later, then again, we'll simplify using that electrical concepts. So there is a contact resistance. This thermal resistance for various solid or solid interfaces, okay, so values are available in the literature. That means in some heat transfer data books. Okay, so whenever in problems, whenever it is required, generally these values will be given in the problems. If it is not required, is not given, so this thermal resistance we can find out from the tables for silicon. So how much aluminum, how much, and brass, some metals. Okay, so this thermal resistance values also all available in the heat transfer data books. So like this, so using electrical analogy or thermal resistance concepts, we can find out the heat transfer in a composite wall. So composite wall is nothing but if it is a combination of more than one layer, it may be a 2 or it may be a 3 or it may be anything. Okay, in such cases, that is called, we can call it as a composite wall. So using for calculate the heat transfer in a composite wall is nothing but delta T by total thermal resistance. So total thermal resistance we can calculate using this equation. Thermal resistance, total thermal resistance equal to, using this equation you can find out total thermal resistance. That if you if you use this formula, you can find out heat transfer. And there is overall heat transfer coefficient. Overall heat transfer coefficient is nothing but again it is a function of total thermal resistance. Using this equation also, again we can find out. So overall thermal resistance, overall heat transfer coefficient. Okay. So this is about next class. We'll discuss how there is heat transfer in the cylindrical element and cylinders. Okay. So with this, today I will stop.